This is another of a series of updates that I will be giving you on the progress of changes that are taking place in the Naval Reserve. While I look forward to seeing you in person, these videos will provide some background to the work that is ongoing within your headquarters and the Navy as a whole. As I mentioned in my initial video, the Naval Reserve is in a process of restoring the part-time and full-time balance in the employment of our reserves. Operational demands of the Navy have overextended the capability of a strategic reserve to support our fourth generation requirements. Last December, the top leadership of the Navy, both regular and reserve, met together to reaffirm the founding principles of our Naval Reserve and our contribution to the maritime defense of Canada. There are three principles that the Naval Reserve was founded upon. First and foremost, we are at our roots a part-time service, composed of people whose occupation is other than continuing full-time service to the Navy. Our training and our taskings must be compatible with the fact of having both a civilian and a military career. Second, we are in our nature a seagoing service whose missions and tasks will primarily prepare us for the challenge of being sailors, not administrators. Thirdly, we are one Navy. We are equal partners in the maritime defense of Canada, respected for our service and professionalism wherever we serve in the fleet. Our missions and tasks that contribute to the maritime defense of Canada reflect the nature of our part-time service and unique capabilities. The Naval Reserve has four strategic tasks that have been assigned to us as our responsibility, ones that you must be familiar with if anyone asks why we have a Naval Reserve. First, we must be able to respond to domestic safety operations, like the Winnipeg flood, with trained sailors and small boat expertise. Second, we provide unique skill sets like port security, inspection dive teams, and naval intelligence for security missions for the Navy. Thirdly, we will augment the fleet on any platform or shore capacity for defense missions, both at home and abroad. Note this third task broadens our mandate to not only provide sailors for the MCDVs, but to frigates and other future platforms as well. Lastly, and perhaps most importantly, we provide the linkage for the Navy to our local communities. We are the Navy's ambassadors by virtue of having a Naval Reserve Division across the country, spreading the message of why Canada needs maritime forces. As a formation, we are undertaking a number of initiatives that will enable us to fulfill the mandate that has been given us. In the next few months, I will be updating you on the changes to our training and policies. My priority is to reduce the backlog of sailors that are awaiting sea time to obtain their qualifications. To this end, two additional MCDVs with a blended crew of regular and reserve sailors will be added to the fleet this summer with a dedicated reserve training mission. These are exciting times of change for the Naval Reserve and for our Navy. As a formation, we are an essential part of the overall maritime defense of Canada and much appreciated for our service. It is up to us to ensure that each of us takes up that challenge to be ready, aye, ready.